Okay, good morning, everyone. Yesterday, we saw the second quarter GDP revisions. They were not really changing that much from the first estimate, meaning that the headline GDP was out at -1%, unchanged from the first estimate. Personal consumption at -1.3%, so basically also unchanged from the first estimate. What we're seeing here is still a huge net contribution, positive contribution from government spending, and also from net exports, since imports in the U.S. are dropping faster than the exports, meaning that if it weren't for the net exports and government spending, the U.S. GDP would be around 2.6 percentage points lower than it was at least on a quarterly basis. Also worth noting is that this is as good as it gets stimulus-wise. In the second quarter and third quarter, we're seeing a net contribution of government spending of a total of 3% annualized, and that contribution is dropping towards 1.5%, something like that, in the Q4, and even less than that in the Q1 of 2010. So this is as good as it gets. Stocks closed higher after having rejected four-day lows. And the euro is edging higher, a sign of optimism versus the US dollar and the yen, despite the fact that the figures were better than expected for the US economy. The high yield universe is slightly underperforming, and this is one of the indications or indicators that we'll be following, as that was leading the markets lower from the mid of 2007. But this is not yet something to be too worried about. So we still maintain this buy and dip stance and believe that the markets could head higher towards the 1121 level, something like that, in S&P 500 in the beginning or mid of October. Yeah. Also beware that in 2 days we'll have elections in Japan, and the LDP, that have been the ruling power for half a decade in Japan, stand to lose landslide. Loss in this election, and the DPJ stands to win. This other party is also about to hand out a lot of benefits to a lot of groups they want to stand on a good foot with. But they are also believed to be able to reform the Japanese economy, and it'll be interesting to see what the yen is doing in this environment. It's already, I believe, the big picture for the past 2 weeks or so. Been a consolidation, but also it'll be interesting to see now that the unemployment rate was out at 5.7% this morning in Japan, if they'll do more reforms to this the huge structural problems that they have. Today we have at 8:30 GMT UK GDP figures, also second estimates or revisions, and we have at 12:30 US PCE figures, meaning inflation figures, and at 14 o'clock GMT, the University of Michigan confidence expected at 64. We have a positive stance on euro-dollar today, also on euro-yen, especially support is rising towards the 134 level, and we believe that we could see a test of 136 on continued optimism. If we look at stocks, our stance is a positive today. By the break of 55.20 in DAX, by the break of 49.10 in FTSE, and by the break of 10.33 in S&P 500. And gold, we are continuing with yesterday's stance, so buy around 9.45 and target 9.56, stop below 9.40. Silver, by the break of 14.50, that looks quite promising, very important level, and target 14.75. Oil, buy and dips towards 72 and target 73.50. The only important earnings out today is before market, and that's Tiffany's, so that'll be interesting.